welcome. This is the second part in which we are studying the human respiratory system. In the first part, we had studied about the upper respiratory tract of the human respiratory system. Now, in this second part, we are going to discuss about the remaining, that is the lower respiratory tract and the respiratory muscles. The lower respiratory tract includes three major parts: trachea, bronchi, one for the right and one for the left lung, and of course the lungs, in which there are the bronchioles, then they terminate into the alveoli. The lower respiratory tract includes trachea, and within the lungs, the bronchi, bronchioles and the alveoli. Now, deep in the lungs, each bronchus divides into the secondary and the tertiary bronchi, which basically have the cartilages. Now, these bronchi further continue to branch into the smaller airways, which are called the bronchioles, and these bronchioles ultimately terminate into smaller airways, which are known as the alveoli, which are the organs where the exchange of gases actually takes place between the inhaled air and the blood, right? So this is the trachea. The trachea basically divides into the bronchi, the right and the left bronchi. These bronchi then divides into the secondary and the tertiary bronchi. Then they have the bronchioles, and the bronchioles ultimately divide into the alveoli, and the alveoli ultimately terminate into a balloon like structure, which are known as the alveolar sacs, where actual process of the exchange of gases takes place. So let us study in the details. Trachea is a long tubular structure which is made up of C-shaped cartilage ring. So these are the C-shaped cartilage ring, and they are 16 to 20 in numbers. As you can see, this is the larynx part, which is in the upper respiratory tract, and this is the tracheal part. So this is the trachea, which has these the cartilages ring, which are incomplete C-shaped cartilages ring, and their function is to maintain the shape of trachea, right? Okay. And these are incomplete rings. So here you can see this is the posterior part. Posterior part mein kya hota hai? Ye esophagus hai. Yahan pe aap dekh sakte ho posterior. Aur anterior part mein hamara ye trachea ka part hai. Right? Now this is the internal lining, which is basically of the pseudostratified ciliated columnar. These cartilage, these C-shaped cartilage rings ensure that the trachea retains its shape and does not stick, and remains open all the times. The trachea basically connects the larynx to the bronchi. The trachea divides into, you can see, right and the left bronchi, which then enter into the respective lungs, and they are known as the primary bronchi, which further divides into the secondary and the tertiary, and then into the bronchioles. Now the mucus, which is present inside, these are the mucus glands. You can see these are the mucus glands. Okay, mucus glands, they basically keep moist the internal surface of the trachea, and when the inhaled air basically comes, they trap the particles. So mucus purifies the inhaled air. The function of trachea is to transport the oxygenated air from the upper respiratory tract when we breathe in inhaled air towards the alveoli for the gaseous exchange. Now the gaseous exchange takes place in the lungs and the terminal part of the bronchiole, which is the alveoli. And of course, to expel the carbon dioxide filled air towards the oral cavity and ultimately from the nostrils for the excretion, for getting rid of the carbon dioxide from the exhaling process. Okay. Now, the bronchi and the bronchioles, the tree. The trachea divides into left and right bronchi. So this is the trachea. So this is the right bronchi and this is the left bronchi, which are known as the primary bronchi. And then they further divide into the secondary bronchi after reaching inside the lungs. So when the primary bronchi, the right and the left bronchi, they reach into the lung, they further divide into the secondary bronchi, right? Secondary bronchi, then they divide into the tertiary bronchi. Till the tertiary bronchi, you can see these, the cartilaginous rings are there. Right, so the cartilaginous airways are up to the tertiary bronchi. Now in the bronchioles, now you can see soft tissues are there and there is no cartilages rings. Okay. Now the secondary bronchi further divides into the tertiary bronchi. These are the tertiary bronchi and then into the bronchioles. So these are the bronchioles. These are the bronchioles. Each bronchiole further divides into smaller bronchioles and then terminates into alveoli, where the actual process of gaseous exchange takes place. So this is the tertiary bronchi. Then tertiary bronchi divides into the bronchioles, bronchioles further divides and ultimately they terminate into these balloon like structures, or you can say they are like the bunch of grapes, and these are known as the alveoli, which are the terminal structures and which are the actual site of exchange of gases. So let us see once again primary bronchi, which is the right and the left primary bronchi. They enter into the lung, they further divide to form the secondary bronchi, then the secondary bronchi further divide to form the tertiary bronchi. Now till this tertiary bronchi there are these cartilages in. Now these tertiary bronchi further they branch into the bronchioles and the bronchioles do not have these cartilages rings. Then the bronchioles further divide and the tertiary bronchioles they end in a structure which is known as the alveoli. These are the alveoli, which are like the bunch of grapes or like the balloons, and when we inhale they basically they inflate and gives a very large surface area for exchange of gases to take place. Now lungs, which are the primary, we can say, organ of the respiratory system where the exchange of gases takes place. A pair of lungs is found just over the diaphragm, one on the left and one on the right side of the chest. The left lung is a little bit smaller because of the heart than the right lung. The lung, left lung is divided only in two lobes. So you can see the first lobe, left upper lobe, and there is this second lobe, which is the lower lobe, whereas you can see in the right there is this upper lobe, this is the middle lobe, and this is the lower lobe. Okay, each lung is made up of spongy tissue which is rich in blood capillaries, and about 30 million alveoli are present. Alveoli are cup shaped structure which are the terminal, which are found at the terminal bronchioles. They are surrounded by rich capillary network. That means the walls of these alveoli are lined by rich capillary networks. Now the rows of squamous epithelium are present in the alveoli wall that helps in the exchange of gases from the blood flowing through the capillaries. Now how does the actual process of gaseous exchange takes place in lungs, or we can say it takes place, how it takes place in the alveoli, which is the actual site of gaseous exchange in lungs. So what happens, the deoxygenated blood comes into the capillary network from the pulmonary artery through the heart, right? Now and when we inhale, the inhaled air comes into the alveolar sac and inflates the alveolar sac. Now this inhaled air has high concentration of oxygen but low concentration of carbon dioxide. So what happens, the deoxygenated blood has low concentration of oxygen but high concentration of dissolved carbon dioxide. So there is a concentration gradient which is established. So what happens, the oxygen from the higher concentration which is present in the inhaled air across the walls of the alveolar sac and the capillary, it diffuses into the deoxygenated blood. As soon as it enters into the blood, the hemoglobin which is present in the deoxygenated blood chemically binds this oxygen and makes oxyhemoglobin, which is bright red in color. Also what happens, the dissolved carbon dioxide which is high in concentration in the deoxygenated blood, it diffuses out into the alveolar sac cavity. Why? Because the concentration of carbon dioxide is less in the inhaled air. So because of this concentration gradient, the oxygen diffuses inside the deoxygenated blood and the hemoglobin becomes oxyhemoglobin, and the carbon dioxide dissolved in the oxygen deoxygenated blood, it diffuses out into the alveolar sac into the inhaled air. So when the progressive movement of this blood through the capillary network takes place, it becomes more and more oxygenated and it gets rid of the carbon dioxide. Now the alveolar air, when it becomes high concentration, when the concentration of carbon dioxide becomes higher and the oxygen becomes lower, it is exhaled, and this process continues, and this gaseous exchange is a continuous process which always takes place, which is continuously taking place inside our lungs. So gas can dissolve and diffuse between the lungs and the circulation system, and this is how the blood becomes oxygenated and the carbon dioxide gets removed or excreted from the respiratory tract. Now the respiratory muscles, they help us to breathe, that means to inhale and to exhale. Now mainly two muscles are involved in this breathing action, that is inhalation and exhalation. The major is the diaphragm. It is a thin sheet like structure made up of skeletal muscles. Now its contraction causes inhalation and its relaxation causes exhalation. The intercostal muscles, which are found on the ribs, which help in contraction and relaxation of diaphragm and the movement of rib cage up and down. Now how does the process of inhalation takes place? So let us see what are the steps involved. The inspiratory muscles contract and the diaphragm descends. So what happens when the diaphragm descends नीचे की तरफ आ जाता है diaphragm, और जो ये rib cage में जो inspiratory muscles है, intercostal muscles है, वो क्या होती है, कॉन्ट्रैक्ट होती है, तो ये रिब जो है वो रिब केज क्या होता है, ऊपर की तरफ जाता है, ये ऊपर की तरफ जाएगा इधर की तरफ, और ये जो डायफ्राम है इट विल गो डाउनवर्ड्स. सो लेट अस जस्ट, सो द डायफ्राम, इट डायफ्राम गोज डाउनवर्ड्स एंड द रिब केज गोज अपवर्ड. सो व्हाट हैपन्स इन टोटेलिटी, क्या हो रहा है, पूरा जो ये थोरेसिक कैविटी है या जो जेस्ट कैविटी है उसका वॉल्यूम बढ़ जाता है, उसका वॉल्यूम बढ़ जाता है. द थोरेसिक कैविटी वॉल्यूम इंक्रीजेस. नाउ बिकॉज ऑफ दिस इंक्रीज इन वॉल्यूम द प्रेशर इनसाइड दिस थोरेसिक कैविटी गेट्स रिड्यूस्ड. द लंग्स आर स्ट्रेच्ड एंड द इंटरपल्मोनरी वॉल्यूम इंक्रीजेस. बिकॉज ऑफ द इंक्रीज इन वॉल्यूम द प्रेशर इनसाइड द लंग्स एंड द थोरेसिक कैविटी डिक्रीजेस. प्रेशर ड्रॉप हो जाता है, कितना हो जाता है, -1 mm ऑफ Hg. Now because this pressure is less than the atmospheric pressure, the air from the outside, that means air from the atmosphere, it gushes inside. The air flows from the nostrils through the pharynx to the larynx, then into the trachea to the lungs, because of this difference in the pressure gradient, until the pulmonary pressure becomes zero. तो वो lungs अंदर, वो जो बाहर की हवा है वो अंदर आती रहती है, कब तक, जब लंग्स के अंदर और एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर बराबर नहीं हो जाता, मतलब उनके बीच का जो डिफरेंस है वो जीरो नहीं हो जाता. तो दिस इज हाउ द इनहेलेशन प्रोसेस टेक्स प्लेस. क्या होता है, जो डायफ्राम है वो नीचे की तरफ आता है, डायफ्राम डिसेंट्स, कॉन्ट्रैक्ट होता है, डिसेंट नीचे की तरफ आता है, और जो रिब केज है वो ऊपर की तरफ आता है बिकॉज ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ द इंटरकॉस्टल मसल्स. ठीक है, और जिसकी वजह से जो वॉल्यूम है थोरेसिक कैविटी का, चेस्ट कैविटी का इंक्रीज हो जाता है, लंग्स का वॉल्यूम भी इंक्रीज हो जाता है, एंड देयर फोर द प्रेशर ड्रॉप्स. नाउ बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेशर इन द एटमॉस्फेयर इज हायर एंड द प्रेशर इनसाइड द लंग्स एंड द थोरेसिक कैविटी इज लोअर, द एयर फ्रॉम आउटसाइड इट रशेज इनसाइड द लंग्स, द इनहेलेशन टेक्स प्लेस. कब तक होता है, जब तक लंग्स के अंदर का प्रेशर और एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर बराबर नहीं हो जाता. सो दिस इज द प्रोसेस विच टेक्स प्लेस. ओके, नाउ लेट अस सी हाउ द प्रोसेस ऑफ एक्सेलेशन टेक्स प्लेस. ओके, सो इनहेलेशन, डायफ्राम कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स एंड मूव्स डाउनवर्ड, रिब केज मूव्ड आउटवर्ड, वॉल्यूम ऑफ द थोरेसिक कैविटी इंक्रीजेस एंड द एयर मूव्स फ्रॉम द सराउंडिंग इनटू द लंग्स. दिस इज विच वी डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस स्लाइड. ओके, नाउ हाउ द एक्सेलेशन टेक्स प्लेस, इट इज जस्ट द रिवर्स केस. सो व्हाट हैपन्स इन द एक्सेलेशन प्रोसेस, लेट अस वंस अगेन सी. द डायफ्राम रिलैक्सेस एंड मूव्स अपवर्ड. सो द डायफ्राम इज मूविंग अपवर्ड, यू कैन सी डायफ्राम रिलैक्स हो जाती है और ऊपर की तरफ जाती है, और ये जो रिब्स हैं वो भी क्या हो जाते हैं, वो भी अंदर की तरफ आते हैं, रिब केज अंदर की तरफ आते हैं। सो व्हाट हैपन्स इन टोटलिटी, दी थोरेसिक कैविटी जो चेस्ट कैविटी है उसका वॉल्यूम डिक्रीज हो जाता है, उसका वॉल्यूम डिक्रीज हो जाता है, और ये जो डिक्रीज वॉल्यूम है वो लंग्स के ऊपर भी प्रेशर डालता है। सो इलास्टिक लंग्स रिकॉइल पैसिवली और इंटर पल्मोनरी वॉल्यूम, ये वॉल्यूम डिक्रीज हो गया, वॉल्यूम डिक्रीज हुआ तो लंग्स के अंदर का प्रेशर इंक्रीज हो जाता है। सो इंटर पल्मोनरी मीन्स लंग्स का जो प्रेशर है वो इंक्रीज होकर +1 mm ऑफ Hg है, जो एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर से ज़्यादा हो जाता है। नाउ व्हाट हैपन्स, बाहर प्रेशर कम है एटमॉस्फेयर में और अंदर ज़्यादा है, इसीलिए ये लंग्स से क्या होता है, एक्सेल होता है। दी एयर फ्लोज आउट फ्रॉम दी लंग्स बिकॉज ऑफ दी प्रेशर ग्रेडियंट, कब तक, जब लंग्स में और बाहर का प्रेशर बराबर नहीं हो जाता। सो दिस इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ एक्सेलेशन विच टेक्स प्लेस इन दिस फैशन और इन दिस मैनर। सो डायफ्राम रिलैक्सेस एंड मूव्स अपवर्ड, द रिब केज मूव्स इनवर्ड, द थोरेसिक कैविटी वॉल्यूम डिक्रीजेस, फोर्सेस द एयर आउट ऑफ द लंग्स विच रिजल्ट्स इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ एक्सेलेशन। आई थिंक दिस इज क्लियर टू यू। ओके, सो लेट अस गो टू द नेक्स्ट। नाउ द प्रोसेस ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन इज कंप्लीटेड इन टू लेवल्स, दीज आर नोन एज द लेवल्स ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन। सो वॉट आर दीज टू लेवल्स, फर्स्ट इज द एक्सटर्नल रेस्पिरेशन विच वी नो बाय द नेम ऑफ ब्रीदिंग, इनहेलेशन एंड एक्सहेलेशन, एंड द सेकेंड इज एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेज बिटवीन द ब्लड फ्लोइंग इन द कैपिलरी नेटवर्क एंड द टिश्यूज थ्रू द डिफ्यूजन प्रोसेस, दिस इज नोन एज द इंटरनल रेस्पिरेशन। सो लेट अस गेट इन टू द डिटेल्स। सो वॉट हैपन्स वेन द ब्लड, दैट इज द डी ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड कम्स थ्रू द पल्मनरी आर्टरी इन टू द लंग्स एंड स्पेशली टू द एल्वियोलाई एल्वियोलर सैक, एंड द एल्वियोलर सैक हैज रिच नेटवर्क ऑफ कैपिलरीज, एंड वेन वी इनहेल द एयर, इनहेल्ड एयर इज हाई इन ऑक्सीजन बट लो इन कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, बट द डी ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड हैज हाई अमाउंट ऑफ डिजॉल्व कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बट लो ऑक्सीजन। सो बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ डिफ्यूजन द एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेज टेक्स प्लेस, द कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड डिफ्यूजेस आउट फ्रॉम द डी ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड इन टू द एल्व्यूलर सैक कैविटी, एंड द ऑक्सीजन फ्रॉम द इनहेल्ड एयर थ्रू द एल्व्यूलर सैक डिफ्यूजेस इन टू द ब्लड। नाउ एज सून एज द ऑक्सीजन एंटर्स द ब्लड, द रेड ब्लड सेल्स द बाइंड केमिकली बाइंड टू दिस ऑक्सीजन एंड बिकम्स ऑक्सीहीमोग्लोबिन, एंड प्रोग्रेसिवली द ब्लड बिकम्स रिचर इन ऑक्सीजन एंड इट बिकम्स ऑक्सीजनेटेड एंड द कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड गेट्स रिमूव्ड फ्रॉम द डी ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड। नाउ दिस कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इज देन रिलीज इन टू द एनवायरमेंट थ्रू द प्रोसेस ऑफ एक्सेलेशन। सो दिस एक्सचेंज ऑफ gases which takes place in the lungs is known as the external respiration, which involves the inhalation and the exhalation process. So this is known as the external respiration. Now what happens when this oxygenated blood through the different arteries goes to a particular part of the body through the systemic circulation, and when it reaches to that certain part it branches into the arterioles, and the arterioles further divide into the capillary network which is the micro blood circulatory vessels. Now the capillaries have very thin walls, so the diffusion can take place easily. So when they go into the tissues, what happens, further the exchange of gases takes place, the oxygen from the hemoglobin it basically goes into the tissues and the cells which need the oxygen for the breakdown of glucose and for the release of energy, and the carbon dioxide which is present because of the process of breakdown of glucose, this carbon dioxide which is higher in concentration in the cells it diffuses into the oxygenated blood. So when it travels progressively, the oxygen is taken up by the tissues and the cells, and the carbon dioxide from the tissues and the cells diffuses into the blood. So the blood ultimately becomes deoxygenated, and this deoxygenated blood once again comes through the inferior and the superior vena cava into the heart. So this exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide which takes place between the blood and the tissues and the cells is known as the internal respiration. So these are the two levels of respiration which together completes the whole process of respiration. I think this is now clear to you. So thank you very much for watching. I hope that you have understood this presentation.